My name is Walter Watson. I'm a retired United States Air Force colonel. I spent almost 5 years flying the SR-71 Blackbird behind me. I am the first, last, and only African-American to qualify to be a crew member in the SR-71. I served on the SR-71 Blackbird as a reconnaissance systems officer, RSO. That was my job. My job was to make sure that the airplane was electronically defended and to operate the various sensor systems on the airplane. Most of the RSOs will tell you, we had to learn both cockpits. They didn't have to learn our cockpit. We had to know their cockpit far better than we knew our own cockpit, because their cockpit got us home. It wasn't that I decided when I got in the Air Force, I'm gonna fly the SR-71. It didn't happen that way. The SR-71, late 60s, was very, very low profile. You kind of heard about it, but you didn't know anything about that. This airplane cruised at 2,000 miles an hour. If you're not doing 2,000 miles an hour, it's like driving around in your car with one foot on the brake and one foot on the gas. This designed for its mission. Extremely high, 16 miles up, over 85,000 feet, and moving at 2,000 miles an hour. That's faster than a bullet. You may see the Mach meter head over toward Mach 1, and because as you go transonic, it does a little ditter and then it proceeds over. So you don't have that big rush or a whole lot of physical feeling. The biggest thing that happens to you is you're in a spacesuit. And inside the spacesuit, everything that you do, you share it with yourself intimately. Normally, you know a few days in advance where you're gonna go and what you're gonna do. Brian and I operated in just about every place on this globe, in the European area, in the Caribbean area, in the Southeast Asian area. A typical mission for us in the backseat, we may have an all-optical sensor package, we may have a radar package. We're always gonna be doing some type of electronic intelligence, if you will. Hardest thing about all of that is keeping track of what's going on with the various sensors, because things are happening quite fast when you're moving at 33 miles a minute. If they said all of their ships are in port, are they in fact in port? That's the kind of information we went out after, which gave the National Command Authority a chance to be able to negotiate from a position of knowledge and power. The thing that got your attention is when you knew that somebody was looking at you and they intended to end your weekend. And when you picked up those signals, that was the time when Brian and I had to be able to communicate. If we can go faster, we can defeat most threats. It was a great experience, a very challenging experience, and an experience that opened up lots of opportunities, not just for me, but for the people who were around me.